Chapter 8. Dreamwalking in a Winter Wonderland.
"Look, girls!" shouted Applebloom. "A shooting star!"
She pointed her little hoof at the sky and jumped up. It was a gorgeous night, clear and bright, revealing a dark canopy pinpricked with stars. The field was covered in snow, but the air felt quite warm and comfortable. So strange this time of moon, but perfect for a party.
"I hope more of those decide to show up, Princess Luna, once Princess Luna gets here,"
added Sweetie Belle cheerily. She was dragging a massive trampoline, painted to look like the surface of the moon through the snow. Wouldn't that just be like a sad reminder? Never mind.
"It really goes with our theme."
"Can somebody help me with these lanterns?" Scootaloo pleaded. She teetered on one hoof at the top of a tall ladder. "I'm too short to reach the string." Her tiny orange wings flapped, but still could not hold her up enough to fly. Bop! Princess Luna had entered Applebloom's dream in the form of a white bunny with black splotches, mirroring her real-life cutie mark. Since Luna's intent was to observe and not to interfere, the little ponies did not notice her hopping under hoof. She stood up on her hind bunny paws and inspected the scene, nose twitching. I didn't know Luna could shapeshift. Kick ass. There were tables set up, elaborate game booths, and a dance floor as big as the Canterlot Castle ballroom. A platform stage stood at the front, ready for a big demonstration, like the raising of the moon. It was just as Luna suspected. The three cutie mark crusaders had gone and planned the Winter Moon Festival anyway.
"I finished setting up the moon mounts," Sweetie Belle squeaked. "Come on, let's bring out the props for the Take a Picture with Princess Luna photo booth."
Three fillies scrambled toward a big crate and began to pull out hats and fake mustaches. Scootaloo put on a beak and started to dance. Oh god, come on, guys. That's old.
"Scrap!"
she giggled, flapping her hands around.
"Look, I'm a chicken!"
Yeah, no shit, Scootaloo. A photo booth? Props? How humiliating. This festival had to be stopped. Now. Jeez, what's her problem? Princess Luna closed her eyes and readied herself. The trio was so entranced by their own cleverness that they didn't even notice that a few feet behind them, a small bunny was growing to the size of an alicorn.
Big bunny!
Magic lights surrounded her body. Princess Luna emerged as her real self.
"Princess Luna!"
Applebloom spun around, shocked, her pink bow bouncing. The royal pony bowed her head.
"Greetings, young fillies."
"What are you doing here?"
Applebloom yelped.
"The Winter Moon Festival hasn't started yet. It's supposed to be a surprise."
Her face was rife with disappointed.
"Do you like it?"
asked Applebloom, motioning to the eyesore around them.
"We've been working on this all for you."
Princess Luna looked around at the setup. There were far too many decorations for Luna's taste. Not to mention that everything was overdone, loud, and exactly as if a filly had designed it. Or three of them, to be precise. Applebloom, Scootaloo, and Sweetie Belle looked up at her with their large, expectant eyes.
"It is creative," Luna tilted her head to the side, unsure of how else to react. Even though it was only a dream, Princess Luna didn't want to hurt poor Applebloom's feelings. Clearly, the young pony was stressed about the event. The fact that she was having this dream proved it.
"Well, phew, that's a relief."
Applebloom seemed pleased enough. She looked around with a puzzled expression.
"I wonder where every pony is, though. They were supposed to start getting here by now."
A laugh escaped from Luna as it dawned on her. Applebloom still didn't realize that she was dreaming. Usually when Princess Luna appeared, the dreamer was aware that they were being visited in their subconscious. But Applebloom was perceiving this exchange as the real event, which meant Princess Luna could alter it to her liking. She could make this festival as weird and silly as she wanted, through the power of dream suggestion. Then Applebloom would think it was her idea.
If there was one thing Princess Luna couldn't resist, it was a harmless prank. She couldn't help the sneaky smirk on her face as she trotted over the stage. Do you mind if I make a few suggestions before the guests arrive?
Of course!
Eagle Apple Bloom nodded. She scrunched her nose.
Like what?